Children, today we are going to discuss about the continent Europe. As you know that there are seven continents in the world. They are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe, and Australia. Europe is the sixth continent in terms of area and the second smallest continent in the world. It has 44 countries. Russia is the largest country in Europe as well as in the world. Most of the Europe lies towards the northern and eastern hemisphere. Look at the map of Europe in the world. Yes. Can you identify Europe over there? Yes. It is Europe. Let us now identify the boundaries of Europe. To the north of Europe, there lies Arctic Ocean. This ocean is frozen throughout the year. So, Arctic Ocean forms the northern boundary of Europe. To the west of Europe, there lies Atlantic Ocean, which separates the two continents, Europe and North America. Towards its south, Mediterranean Sea forms the boundary of Europe. It separates North Africa with southern part of Europe. It is called Mediterranean Sea because it lies in the center of the world. Children, can you identify the mountains towards the eastern side? Yes, these are the Ural Mountains. These mountains form the eastern boundary of Europe. Now identify all the boundaries of Europe. To the north, Arctic Ocean. To the west, Atlantic Ocean. To the south, Mediterranean Sea. To the east, Ural Mountains. Now let us talk about mountains, plains and rivers. Europe has several snow-capped mountains. The Alps is the most important mountain ranges of Europe. The Caucasus Mountains, which lies between the Caspian Sea and the Black Sea, form the southern boundary of Europe. There are no large plateaus in Europe. Some small plateaus are there in France, Germany, and Spain. You can identify the underlying countries in Europe, that is Germany, France, and Spain. Eastern Europe is a vast plain which stretches across several countries like Russia, Ukraine, Poland, Belarus, etc. Look at the physical map of Europe. You can identify many rivers over there. Some of the rivers of Europe are Rhine, Volga, Oder, Dnieper, etc. You can identify all the rivers of Europe in your textbook on page number 46. Now let us move forward towards peninsulas, islands, bays and gulfs. The seacoast of Europe is very jagged. Jagged means zigzag. It is not straight. Italy is surrounded on three sides by the sea. Can you identify Italy on the map over there? Yes, down to the southern part of Europe. In the box, you can see a country called Italy. It is a peninsula. What is a peninsula? A landmass that are surrounded by sea on three sides and connected to the mainland on the fourth side are called peninsula. India is also a peninsula. It is covered three side water and to the north it is attached with the land. Some more peninsula in Europe are Spain and Portugal Peninsula and Scandinavian Peninsula. Can you see the peninsulas over there? Yes. Scandinavian Peninsula to the north consists of Sweden and Norway. The presence of large number of bays and gulfs has also facilitated the use of sea routes. Bays and gulfs are parts of the sea enclosed by land on three sides. The mouth of the bay is usually wide, whereas a gulf is a narrow inlet in the sea. Can you see Baltic Sea on the map over there? Yes, it's a bay. And down you can see a gulf beside Italy. The entire Baltic Sea is a large gulf. There are many islands surrounding Europe. Britain or England is an island. An island is a landmass which is covered by water on all sides. Children to the extreme north can identify one of the island called Iceland. Down beside to the Britain, you have one more island, it is Ireland. Down in the Mediterranean Sea, there are some more islands too. Now moving forwards, let us discuss about the climate of Europe. Europe is cooler than our country. The region near the equator remain warm all round the year. As we move northwards or southwards away from the equator, it gets cooler and cooler. The polar regions are covered with ice all round the year. The climate of Europe is influenced by Atlantic Ocean. The impact is felt more by the regions along the Atlantic Ocean. The winds which blow from the west are called westerlies. The climate of Europe is affected. Now you can see the westerlies over there in the map. The climate of Europe is mostly affected by these western winds called westerlies. Look at the map of westerlies over there. The water in the ocean is not static. They move. And those are called as warm ocean currents. Ocean currents are actually the ocean water which moves in one direction. The ocean currents originates near the equator are warm ocean currents, flows towards America and advances towards northeast, hits the western coast of Europe. This is known as Gulf of Stream in America and North Atlantic Drift in Europe. Can identify a stream over there? Yes, a stream which is moving towards the west and then again move to the northeastern, northwestern part of Europe. Streams are the ocean water which flows speedily. Okay, children, for now, we'll stop here with the lesson. Let us recapitulate. We have discussed today about the boundaries of Europe, the physical features of Europe that contains mountains, plains, rivers, bays and gulfs, and also we have discussed about warm ocean currents and gulf streams. Note down the assignment for today. Mark mountains and rivers on the outline map of Europe. Okay, children, we'll meet in the next topic again.